Welcome to the Jamaica Funk Show with KT on Spreaker.com. Well, I know. Good evening and welcome to the Jamaica Funk Show. I'm KT, I'm your host, and this evening we got a great show for you. We have our guest tonight, that is Reverend Catherine Jackson, and she's going to be talking about one of her neighborhood initiatives that she's got going on and an event that she's got coming up this coming Thursday. So we're going to be talking about that. We're going to be talking about peace in the hood here in Chicago, because there's a lot of stuff going on, and you know, they're really, really trying to stop the chaos that's going on. I don't want to label it anything else other than chaos, because destruction is just that, chaos. So we're looking at a peace initiative to bring about some joy and some happiness for those families down there whose children can't even go outside on the porch and play, let alone probably even play in the house for fear of a bullet coming through their windows or their children being shot while they're outside playing. So we got that. We got some reggae music. We got some Christmas music. And we got some poetry. So without any further ado, I want you to sit back, relax, grab whatever it is that you're eating and drinking, and let's get ready for some Shona. Mama, shut your mouth. Reggae music. Well, I remind.
Connection. 41st, shout out to my man Vibes Cartel. All my Portmore shotters.
Wayne,
I see you, Wayne. My Kingston Root Boys. You know, we dips at monsters, man. So Wayne, just holler at him.
Straight off the top. We can't afford to stop. We gonna top the pops. Wait till this Jamaica drops. We gonna make it clear. We gonna take it there.
Boy, I'm what you call a shotter with a shotty boy, popping at you botty boy. Pond the river, pond the bank, row your boat. Oh no, it's boatloads of coke. Yeah. And we got pounds of kiki, that's brown and green weed. Think you found a kiwi. Yeah. We lock it down for sheezy, lock it down, it's easy. Clown around, I squeeze three. Yeah. You might catch me packing the 4/5 after a good plate of Samaki and Swordfish. Yeah. I take a plane straight from the East End, fly straight into Kingston, Coane and his peeps, man. Yeah, we get to bang in the streets, man, bang in the heat, man, we pay the police, man. Yeah, we don't go to jail for this, we won't go to jail for shit, now run, go and tell your bitch.
Straight off the top, we can't afford to stop, we gonna top the bus, wait till this Jamaica drops, we gonna make it clear.
Immunity from Portmore City
to Harlem community. No thanks for the opportunity. No reggae and hip hop hand in hand like love and unity. Me come collect with you to me, Benjamin. Crazy props, platinum from out the shops. We are furs like the fox, flow sick like anthrax, pandan tracks. We used to fire shots, now we call the shots. No need to call the cops. Every day, GBJ, Mr. Jewel, in a crazy throwback with matching old school. Them and Marshall, take it to the fools. Vibes cartel style, technological, like Pro Tools. When we roll, people watch for more than the nightly news. Them say, up to the time, that's the slang we're widely used. When is the right time we choose? Forget record sales bigger than the sale of the Nike shoes.
Timeless. Yeah, that's who we are. Straight dogs and superstars. They never know we would have reached this far. No hip hop and dance all apart.
Jimmy Rankins, rude boys fight for white, they pumping. You know Harlem's hard, like kings of Jamaica down in the bottom, y'all. Yes, we bringing that paper, coming in charge of cards. See my paper so ill, is it Jamaica for real? I'm going straight in the grill, that's where they naked for real. Cruise through the ghetto with Wayne. We got them foreign the plates, you know my ghetto's the same. Up in them foreign estates, man. You know it's terrible things, we got the horrible fate. Rude boy shotters that move on shotters. Fuckers, twos go blockers, can't do us nada. Dipset mobsters, we done connected with some Kingston rosters. Shit, hit the block, kill a dread. Strip a block, fill a dead. Lick a shot, kill him dead.
You're listening to the Jamaica Funk Show with KT. Well, I remain.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas.
So guys, listen, tonight I have the privilege to have a guest that I've been friends with for some time, and she's just a really great person, an all-around great human being. Just a very, very smart lady, and she's a God-fearing woman. Ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, give it up for Reverend Catherine Jackson. What's up, Rev?
Hey, you what's up? You what's up? You asking me what's up? You have taken this music and community by storm. You what's up, KT? You the one that's up. You're funky and you're intelligent. You're brilliant. You got it going on. And I'm proud to be your sister.
Well, thank you. I'm proud to have you as my sister because you ain't sure stopping your own self.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Yeah, so right. Sweet. All right, just going to call me sweet, y'all. Let me give you some of her accolades. Now, first of all, she's a community leader in Chicago, okay? So she walking around upsetting some apple carts around here. She's a former community project leader for the Black Star Project, which is one of our well-known projects right here, not project as in housing project, but projects in terms of community initiatives here in Chicago. she's also she's the former project manager of We Can Careers in the Arts for the Youth and Fierce Women of Faith Summer Arts Project. And tonight we're going to talk about a new initiative that she's got coming up and an event that she's got coming up this coming Thursday, which is Restorative Justice Hub program, correct?
Yeah, it's a Woodline Restorative Justice Hub.
Okay, so tell us about that particular program.
Okay, this program was started by Dr. Maddie Butler and Alice Goldberg with the STOP organization over back in 2016. Was prior for me that were coming on board as a volunteer. I've been a volunteer mentor. And it's a program to address the issues of various gangs in the Woodlawn area. It's really just dealing with young people that to respond to the violence in our community, actually taking the young people by the hand or by the heart, working with them, talking to them about conflict resolution, peace circle, resume writing, looking at ways in which how we can all get along together, and looking at ways how these future leaders, young men and young ladies, how we can all not look at violence as an option, but look at peace as a way of peace, love, and justice as a way to move our community in a positive light.
Yeah, so what's your take on a lot of this violence that has been going on in the community? Because, you know, actually the level of violence has come down in Chicago, but it is still very, very alive and kicking.
Well, first, as a mother, as a grandmother, as a person that's involved in the community, as a minister, you know, all these different hats that we wear, but as a human being, it's very sad because when I look at the young people that look at violence as a means to resolve an issue, it's very unhealthy. We have a health crisis in our community when we look at violence. We have another health issue in our community when we look at violence. We have an economic issue when we look at violence. We have a self-esteem, confidence issue when we look at violence. It's all interrelated. So that we have to, so when I look at it, my heart is heavy because violence has an impact on not just individual that is actually been inflicted by the violence, whether it's by guns or however we might define it, but it also it's like a rooted tree that the branches go out and it impacts everybody. It may not impact your home today, but indirectly it does. It impacts how we see each other. It impacts what happens with us regarding our job, our schools, and all of that. Some people, when they talk about Chicago, all they can remember for some is about the violence in Chicago. So it's a very sad place, but it's not impossible for us to address the issues of violence in our community. And violence is not just about the guns and the knives and the fighting, but it's also the emotional violence, the abuse that happens in our community. So the program that we deal with, and there are other hubs, restorative justice hubs, we are actually looking at the different within our young people. There are different gangs in our community, and we have taken some of those young people together, and we are sitting down with them in a peace circle environment and talking about themselves and talking about the community and talking about them as a group and looking at ways in which we could be able to help build them up and help look at that, because I do believe that one size does not fit all. I believe that you have to take people where they're at, and that you look at them and you look at the beauty and you look at the gifts that God has given them, and you be able to mentor them and to be able to find resources to connect with our young people.
You know, I believe that part of the problem is that we don't look at the words that we plant. And what I mean by the words that we plant, you know, you being a reverend, word is seed. And whatever falls out of our mouth gets planted in the ether and it grows in its own way, but it grows. It shows up. And so I think one of the things that we need to be conscious of is our speaking. How we call it, because instead of calling it violence, you know, we have to give it some kind of name, because violence beget violence. And as long as we keep calling it violence, this is just my thinking. It's going to continue to be violence. I think when we start saying, you know, because what we want is peace. And so instead of speaking of what we don't want, which is the violence, let's speak about the peace, because the peace is what we want. And if we speak about the peace, we will call that peace into being, because, you know, there is craziness going on all around. I mean, you know, Chicago may have the guns, but Chicago not only have the guns, they got the opioid epidemic, and that is causing all kinds of, you know, crimes to show up, you know, and it also attributes to what you're dealing with, because a lot of it is it has to do with drugs and stuff of that nature. You know, people, you know, got caught up in the rat race. And so I think that there's a lot of things that we're going to have to deal with, but I think we're going to have to start calling it what it is we want to show up versus what we're trying to get rid of.
You're right about that. And out from a book that I read by Emily Towns, she talks about, in the same video you're referring to, that we have to deconstruct and reconstruct a new way of thinking, and we have to change And we do have to change our words. Mm-hmm. We have to be able to do that. We have to speak truth, recognize our mistakes, and recognize the things that we as we tell our young people or we tell our community. I mean, we as an adult that at times believe because we've been there and done that, that we have all the answers. We don't have all the answers.
Absolutely.
But we can part of this whole process is to listen with an open ear, but also listen to understand. We have to listen to understand. I've learned through a method of communication that sometimes we listen, but we don't listen to understand. And I agree with you that it does take words, but I also agree with you too, it also takes action. It also takes action. Mm-hmm. And action is you gotta move it. You gotta make things happen, and you mm-hmm. gotta show people, and working with our young people, we gotta show them that we care, we gotta show them that we listen. We got to show that we understand. And then we together got to be able to provide the tools to clear our ways more in order to address the issues at hand. And it's like incarceration in our own community based on the things that's happening around us.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's actually, you know, I look at that incarceration bit as just it's just a reenactment of slavery. Mm-hmm. it just got a new name called incarceration. That's
right,
all that
right,
is.
Right.
You know, and pluck them where you can get them from, however you can
right,
get them.
Right.
You know, it reminds
me. Like Michelle Alexander book. you know that she talks about the same thing. You
yeah,
know,
yeah.
We are reliving it, and
yeah.
We, in our own community, we take on those same characteristics that they talk about
yeah.
in the letter. We
yeah.
become our own enemy by the things that we say and the things that we do.
Yeah, and I believe that we have been that because of our conditioning. We've been conditioned to be that away, and until we become present to that we are conditioned
right.
to, that's going to be a vicious circle that we're going to keep running in.
Right.
You know, but
it
the incarceration reminds me of 12 years a slave.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the two guys who just got out of prison who served 20 years in jail for a rape that they did not even commit. And what exonerated mm-hmm. them was the DNA evidence. And
mm-hmm.
and it's the same premises as the guy in 20 Years a Slave. He was abducted by some white guys,
mm-hmm.
and cast into slavery, you know.
Right.
And he wasn't a slave. He was actually a freeman. But he became a slave
mm-hmm.
for 12 years. And it's the
years.
Same as these two brothers. They became
mm-hmm.
a slave for 20 years. And finally, you know, DNA, praise the Lord for DNA, or as Madea called it, Dana. But praise the Lord for it. You know, it saved them. But this is something that we, you know, that's compound on top of what you're trying to deal with. You know,
right.
And so.
Right.
You know, the great thing about it nowadays, you have these organizations that have come together, like they have the billionaires organization. I'm not sure of what the name of it is, but it's a bunch of billionaires who've gotten together, wealthy people who've gotten together, and they've created this justice fund to
uh-huh.
get innocent low income and poor, you know, incarcerated men and women out of jail. You know,
right,
they've just
right.
created this fund, and I'm actually very, very happy that has
okay.
come about, because there's so many guys in jail. They're in jail because they can't afford bail. They're
right.
totally innocent, But they're spending years in jail because they can't afford bail.
Right, right. You're right about
That's crazy.
That is so true.
So, Catherine, now tell us about this event that you got on and how this what you guys are doing and how the community can support you all.
What I'd like to say is that this program has been supported by the Cook County Department. And what we're doing is that it's really, if the program officially ended on November the 30th, but what we're doing now is actually trying to find ways to raise funds so that we can continue the program and support our young people. Because when they're in our 12-week program, it's between 12 and 14 weeks, they actually receive a stipend through the training that they go through and those peace circle they're involved with, and we help them to get on the, we help them to really look at creative ways to establish what I call a social, you know, continue to build their social skills. Mm-hmm. So what we have is, what we're doing on December 7th on this Thursday at between 5:30 and 7:30, we're having a special celebration to recognize our young people that have been part of the program. And two, we're looking at this as a means to try to raise funds to continue the program to support our young people. As a volunteer, as the program director, because it's a volunteer process, we hope to invite the community through Maddie Butler and to actually do a fundraiser. We're having a light refreshments. We're having performance by Miss Keisha's Faison. She'll be performing with her band. And this is just a really upbeat place to really look at working together in our community makes a difference.
So now you say this is a charitable event. It's a fundraiser.
Yes. Okay. It's a fundraiser, and we're very open. We've made a decision today. Those that just to come on and celebrate with us, if they're unable to pay for a ticket, make a donation, just come anyway and let us highlight and celebrate our young people. But now, the title of our event is called A Season of Dreams. Okay. We don't want people to just dream. We want people to actually walk in their dream. We want our young people to be able to see, hey, there's a different world out here, and you can make it. We have a lot of mentors in our community and a part of our program. We have resources in our community that has informed us that they'd like to be a part of this and help us make our program successful.
And so for those who can't afford to contribute, what is the contribution?
The contribution is $25. The event is being held at the Chicago Theological Seminary. It's at 1407 East 60th Street here in Chicago.
Okay. That's like Stony Island?
Yes, it's by Stony Island, yes.
Okay. Yes. So that's 1407 East 60th Street.
Right. Okay. Chicago Theological Seminary. That's where we're having our event.
Okay.
We're really excited about that. So we'd like for the community to come out and to meet our young people, learn about our program, provide financial contribution. But most of all, we want to be able to celebrate life and celebrate what we're doing and also connect with our young people.
Well, it sounds like you all are really doing something to to bring up the, to uplift the community. Go ahead.
No, I'm sorry.
Yeah, because every little bit helps. Every little bit helps, you know. And, you know, like you said, we all don't have a silver, we may not have a silver bullet, you know, to vanish everything that's going on. But the only way we will find the way to curtail what's going on is by these type of programs, you know, and I think you all warrant being supported, you know. And I don't think $25 is a big donation.
No, it's not.
Especially at this time of year. This is Christmas time, you know. This is when everybody, I don't know, for some reason, everybody have a heart this time of year, you know?
Right. Yeah, it's not. And I just like to give a shout out. There are so many more organizations that are out here in the community that are doing good work, providing mentorship and support to young people. And I just, you know, I can't name them all. Some of them I don't know, but I think it's KT. I think it's such a place in our community to just to say thank you to all of those organizations, whether they have funding or not, the volunteers that are out here helping our young people, because we need that. And with our young men, they need support. Our young ladies need support. And I just want to commend the community for the work that they're doing.
Yes. Yeah, I would like to commend them, too. Catherine, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
You're listening to the Jamaica Funk Show with KT. Well, I remain.
Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse.
In my mind.
Anger issues. I have them. Yes, I do. I can't remember when I didn't. Sometimes when you least expect it, an infinitesimal thought from a time you haven't given thought to in a long time takes advantage of a quiet time, slips in under the radar in a moment of introspection, blasting through like a tidal wave during a day at the park, near the shore, while you're enjoying a glass of Chardonnay with your significant other who just happens to be apologizing again. And it's there. And you really don't have a full memory of why anger is an issue. It just is. But anger is in the details. The first time I rolled my eyes in righteous indignation, my youth clouded my ability to see anything except what I wanted. My eyes rolled clean through my teens. And as time passed, as the years do, my hands made gestures clearly not measured in the least explainable. But whenever the feeling of anger arose, it became clear what the fuse started and ended. With me, externally. Hands raised in the air, fists balled into knots, my fingers splayed, pointing accusations at the offending party. But just when you think that you're going to have a time to cool down, doesn't happen. But your head, it can't stop throbbing because you really didn't realize that your eyes became shot with blood, your face contorted to a point that you can see harsh lines along your cheekbones. But the worst part was feeling your heart race like a herd of stampeding rhino or elephants, and your jaw aching because before you even said a word, you were grinding and gritting your molars so hard, it was what caused the headache in the first place. And you're gripping something balled in your hands and find it's just tissue. Time is not your friend in times like these. And you know it's best to keep your mouth shut, stay out of it. Sometimes, no matter how hard you try, you just can't.
Guys, I'm back. We're back. I'm here with Reverend Catherine Jackson, and we are talking about the Restorative Justice Hub program and her event that she's got going on December the 7th, Thursday?
Yeah.
At what, 5:30?
5:30, yes.
Yeah, at the Theological Society 1407 East 60th Street in Chicago.
Chicago Theological Seminary.
Okay.
And their address is right, 1407 East 60th Street.
So, you wanna tell people how they can reach out to you guys and whatever else you need to say, you know, like if you want to give a shout out, go right ahead and do it.
Well, I'd like to say the volunteers like myself, the mentors that's working, I'd like to shout out to them. I'd like to just have a special, gracious, humble thank you to Maddie Butler, to Alex Goldberg, which is the executive director of the STOP organization. Shout out to David Lee, Charles Harris, Arun, and then also Peaches for their continued work. And then we have so many other volunteers, Venus Scott, to help. So just like to say shout out to them and Kamika for being around and supporting us in our efforts to make things happen. And we have a program at the Universal Church every 3 days a week. It's an intensive 12-week program. I'm proud to say that we're in our fourth session of our Catherine, young people since we started.
So, back Catherine.
In 2016, I was kind of proud of that.
Okay, fine. Catherine. Catherine. So, look, we got to wrap it up. I will make sure I put in the post where the event is going to be at, so you all will be able to, you know, get into or be able to contact Catherine through the information I'll put on the posted on the show. Listen, guys, you know, without you, there is no Jamaica Funk Show, and so I just want to say God bless you. And God bless America. And don't forget to listen in tomorrow evening for Black History Wednesday. And until I see you again tomorrow, well, I remind.